Hello students, today we have a part of our manufacturing class, a section of the manufacturing process which is an important part of that, which is called metal joining process, metal joining process. Now the question is that, is metal joining an important thing in manufacturing? Yes. Why? Because when we wanted to buy a raw material for making any product, that comes in some standard size and shape, depending on what is the production process it has, what is the transportation facility it has to bring it to the place where it is there. Now, because of that, we may have to join many, if it's a road, we need some 3 meter, 4 meter road, and this road comes in 1 meter length, then we have to join two or three of them to get the enough length. So similarly, there are different requirements wherein which we need to know what are the joining methods that we have. So today's class is on metal joining process. My name is Rijo Jacob Thomas. I'm a faculty in Department of Mechanical Engineering, TKM College of Engineering, Kollam, Kerala. Now, whenever we think about metal joining, the most striking one, the first thing which comes to our mind is nothing but the welding process. Now, we may have seen a lot of welding processes. Now, welding comes under a category of category called permanent joints. There can be temporary joints, and we can be a nut, bolt and all. It can be some semi-permanent ones like riveting and all. But this welding comes in a category which is called permanent. Once you weld it, it is permanently, it's supposed to be permanently there, joint. You don't have an option to in between remove it and again attach it. That facility is not there if it's a permanent joint. So welding comes under that category. Now, how do we define this process? A material joining process which produces coalescence of materials by heating them to a suitable temperatures with or without the application of pressure, by the application of pressure alone, or without the use of filler material. So we need to apply temperature. Now pressure is an option, whether you give force along with temperature, that's an option. Now there's a second option, which is whether we need a filler material, a third material in the process or not, is again another option. So based on these differences, we find a lot of different types of weldings. Now used for making permanent joints, and it has got application in anywhere you can think about. Everywhere we can see different applications, different sectors in which welding has got wide applications. Now, the categorization of welding is made, there are different categories. The major one is plastic welding or pressure welding. Other one is fusion welding or non-pressure welding. The plastic welding or pressure welding is the one where we don't really rely on temperature, but it is upon the pressure. The piece of the metal to be joined are heated to a plastic state. Remember, there is not been melted and forced together by an external pressure. Now, resistance welding is an example for it. Fusion welding is the material at the joint is heated to the molten state and allowed to solidify. Now, our gas welding, arc welding and all comes under this fusion welding category or non-pressure category. The other one is the plastic welding category. It doesn't stop there. We have classification, we have multiple processes in welding. In gas welding itself, gas welding, resistance welding, arc welding, there are some new advanced welding, then solid state welding. This is this pressure welding where we have friction welding, ultrasonic welding, diffusion welding, explosive welding and all. The newer ones have got electron beam welding, laser welding and all. Arc welding, we have carbon arc, metal arc, plasma arc, gas metal welding, MIG, TIG, tungsten inert gas welding, metal inert gas welding. We have resistance welding, where there are butt welding, spot welding, seam welding, projection welding, and all. Generally, in the case of pipes and all, we use that. And gas welding, we have oxygen acetylene welding, and air acetylene welding. Let's see some of the major ones here. The very commonly used one is nothing but the arc welding. Let's see that what is arc welding. So what you see here is a person doing an arc welding. So it uses an electric arc to coalesce the metal. Arc welding is the most common method of welding, widely used. And we will see the principle, how it works. It works with a principle that with an electric power supply, whether AC or DC, we maintain an arc gap. If you have an arc gap and there is a high voltage potential between this, there will be definitely arcing happening. There is a lot of arcing happening. And this arcing will give rise to a lot of heat. And this heat will make this material melt. And that's how we do the welding. So two parts are there which need to be welded together, which need to be joined together. In that junction, what we do is we create an arc such that the ends of these metals are melted and they are fused to each other and joined. That's what this happens. So this picture explains that we have a workpiece, we have a facility where which we can make an arc between this part and this part, the work part, and we call that as the electrode part. So the electrode and the workpiece, we make an arc. Because of the arc, there will be material which will be melted, molten material, and this it melts and gets solidified. In the process, the joining of the material has been done. Now, what are the things that we require to do this? Yes, we require a power source, which generally we call as the welding machine, the big block which we see. It is nothing but a power source which can generate. Now, the power source, the power, we have two terminals coming out of it. Two terminals, one positive terminal and one negative terminal. So this terminal one will go into the electrode with an electrode rod. We call as the welding rod, and that will have the other part will be connected to the work, and between this electrode and work we need to maintain a arc gap. If the arc gap is too much, then there will not be any arcing. If the electrode touches the work, then there will be shorting. It will be sticking to it. So we need to ensure that throughout the welding process, the arc gap is being maintained so that it produces the arc. Once it produces the arc, we have the high temperature developed. When we have the high temperature developed, we have the material getting melted, and that's how the welding happens. So for this, we need a generator, a DC or a AC type generator. We need two cables, wires, one to the electrode, one to the workpiece. We need an electrode holder to which we stick, because this electrode is also a consumable electrode. The electrode also gets melted. So the electrode has to be changed in between. So we have an electrode holder. Then we have the positive shield and gloves and all for the safety aspects. And the welding has been done. All right. Now, it has got certain advantages and disadvantages. It's an efficient one, low cost as comparing to others, afford lighter weight, better utilization of materials, joins almost all commercially available, and it is also flexible. But there is a lot of labor cost attached with it. The energy required is high. It is heavy. The machine itself is heavy. And there can be defects due to the proper melting down of joints. All right. And so the we were discussing about the metal joining process, and out of that the main common one is the welding, and in the welding the most commonly used one is arc welding, and we have seen that an arc is produced and the arc will be melting the material and it will create the heat which is required to melt this two materials which has to be joined, and it produces a permanent joint. Thank you, and see you in next class.